In Act 1, we're introduced to Wreck-It Ralph.
I'm gonna wreck it!
The bad guy in the old school video game, Fix-It Felix Jr.
I can fix it!
Even though Ralph is a vital part of his game, no one else appreciates his hard work. He has no friends inside or outside his game, and also, he lives in a dump.
When I say a dump, I don't mean like a shabby place, I mean an actual dump.
With the exception of Felix, who's just a super guy, everyone in Ralph's game despises him. He faces similar oppression from characters outside his game, who fear him because he's a bad guy. And he can't relate to the other bad guys of newer, more violent games.
Right. I'm sorry, you lost me there.
Ralph's Act 1 goal is to come to terms with his place in the video game world. But after decades of mistreatment, Ralph's imperfect situation comes to a head at the Act 1 turning point catalyst, the Disturbance. To celebrate the 30th anniversary of their game, the Nicelanders turn up to the max, hiring Skrillex to DJ and a clown bartender. When Ralph discovers they're throwing a party without him, he storms up to the penthouse to crash it. Although Felix convinces everyone to let him in for a slice of cake, Ralph gets into an argument with Gene, inadvertently smashes the cake, and wrecks the party. Gene tells Ralph he is incapable of doing anything good and will always be a bad guy. Ralph vows to win a medal and prove he's more than the useless scrub everyone thinks he is. This chain of events leads Ralph to the Act 1 turning point, the dilemma. Ralph leaves the party and heads straight to Tapper's in search of guidance. Although Tapper isn't much help, Ralph meets a soldier from the game Hero's Duty, who tells him that in his game, you win a medal for climbing a building and fighting bugs. When the soldier knocks himself out fleeing a bug, Ralph gets the idea to don the soldier's uniform, sneak into Hero's Duty, and win a medal. In doing so, Ralph assumes the new role of a game jumper. In Act 2, Ralph commits a cardinal video game sin by sneaking into Hero's Duty to win a medal. Because Ralph has never played a game outside his own, he's unfamiliar with the nature of the game and thinks winning the medal will be easy. However, he soon discovers that Hero's Duty is a much more dangerous place than he initially concluded. As soon as the game begins, Ralph and his squad are attacked by a swarm of bit-thirsty cybugs. While the bugs incidentally oppose his goal of winning a medal, they're just doing what they're programmed to do, destroy everything. When Ralph causes the player to lose the game, the leader of Hero's Duty, Sergeant Calhoun, berates him for his ineptitude. This chain of events and the events that immediately follow serve as the Act 2 turning point catalyst, the reality check. Although Ralph thought winning a medal in Hero's Duty would be easy, he now realizes there's no way he'll survive through the game. True to his bad guy DNA, Ralph instead decides to steal the medal by climbing the tower and bypassing the game. Although he succeeds in obtaining the medal, while celebrating his victory, he accidentally hatches a cybug egg, activates an escape pod, and crash lands it in the candy go-kart game Sugar Rush. Meanwhile, the little girl whose game of Hero's Duty Ralph ruined decides to play Fix-It Felix Jr. Seeing Ralph is gone, she informs the arcade manager the game is broken, and Ralph's game is labeled out of order. Ralph's escapades have now endangered all the inhabitants of his game. In Sugar Rush, Ralph realizes he's lost his mettle. Before he can recover it, he meets an annoying little gutter snipe, Vanellope, who steals his mettle to use for her own objectives. Ralph vows to get it back from her, committing himself to his new role as a game jumper.
I'll find you! I will find you!
Back in Game Central Station, Felix and Calhoun decide to go into Sugar Rush to find Ralph and the cybug he brought into the game with him, knowing if they die outside their game, they won't regenerate. This brings the lot of them into the central conflict with King Candy and the cybugs in Act 3. In the third act, the character pursues a false goal. For Ralph, this goal is to find Vanellope and take back his mettle. This goal is false because Ralph fails to realize that he must earn his mettle through good deeds. When Vanellope uses Ralph's mettle to buy her way into the race, the only way for Ralph to retrieve his mettle is to help her win the race and prove she's a real racer. By pursuing Vanellope, Ralph inadvertently stumbles into the central conflict between her and King Candy.
That glitch cannot be allowed to reign! And bring that thing to my castle!
We also learn in this act that the cybug Ralph brought into Sugar Rush is still alive and assimilating the game, setting up the fifth act conflict of the cybug invasion. Vanellope intentionally opposes Ralph's goal by using his mettle to buy her way into the race. Also in this act, Ralph is apprehended by King Candy, who intentionally opposes his goal of getting his mettle back at the Act 3 turning point catalyst, the turn. King Candy tells Ralph Vanellope turned his mettle into code and it can't be retrieved.
She did what? I need that back!
Well, I'm afraid I can't help you. It's gone.
This revelation further complicates Ralph's goal of getting his mettle and returning to his game. When the king orders his donuts to deport him from Sugar Rush, Ralph escapes, placing himself at odds with the Candy Empire and bringing him to the Act 3 turning point, the moment of truth. Ralph sees Vanellope being accosted by the other racers and intervenes. This is a pivotal moment for Ralph. Up to this point, most of his actions have been motivated by his own selfish desires. Seeing Ralph's crazy dope wrecking skills, Vanellope convinces him to break into the cart factory, reasoning if she wins the race, she can get his medal back. Ralph makes the decision to help her as a means of accomplishing his own goal. Meanwhile, Felix and Calhoun track down the shuttle Ralph took into Sugar Rush, and he tells her the story of Turbo, the infamous game jumper who destroyed his own game and another with his selfish endeavors. Here we learn the true dangers of game jumping and why the practice is forbidden. In Act 4, Ralph wants to help Vanellope win the race in order to get his mettle back. Together, they break into the go-kart factory and run through the minigame to whip her up some wheels. Even though Ralph is helping Vanellope achieve her own goal, he is still motivated by his own selfish desires. When the king realizes Ralph is helping Vanellope attempt to win the race, he vows to stop them both. By willingly choosing to undermine the king, instead of cutting his losses and returning to his own game, Ralph creates the self-inflicted opposition he faces in this act. Seeing Vanellope is ostracized in her game how he is in his, Ralph builds her a racetrack and tries to teach her how to drive. But Ralph's attempt to help Vanellope win the race in this act is his doomed plan. Although she does learn how to drive, their plan comes unraveled when King Candy confronts Ralph and makes him question his commitment to helping Vanellope win the race. King Candy is revealed to be more than he seems when he unlocks the game's code and retrieves Ralph's medal from the Winner's Cup. He manages to track Ralph down while Vanellope is inside and offers to give Ralph his medal if he convinces her not to race. While Ralph is initially against the idea, the King makes the point that if Vanellope's glitch gets the game placed out of order, as a glitch, she is the only character who'd be trapped in the game when it's unplugged. Reasoning that it's in Vanellope's best interest, the King convinces Ralph to stop her from participating in the race. When Vanellope returns, Ralph tells her that she can't be a real racer. Unable to reason with her, Ralph does the only thing he knows how to do. He wrecks her brand new cart to prevent her from entering the race, seemingly undoing all the good he had done thus far.
You really are a bad guy.
Ralph returns to his own game, only to find it out of order and deserted. Jean berates him for destroying their game for his own selfish desires.
I was just tired of living alone in the garbage.
When Ralph sees Vanellope's face on the side of Sugar Rush, he realizes she isn't actually a glitch and there are sinister plots afoot in her game. Ralph races back to Sugar Rush, finds the King's right-hand piece of candy, Sour Bill, and saliva boards the truth out of him. Meanwhile, Calhoun discovers the Cybug Nursery and realizes Sugar Rush is doomed. In Act 5, Ralph finally realizes the ultimate goal of the story: defeat King Candy and help Vanellope win the race. We also learn in this act that King Candy is actually the infamous game jumper Turbo, who has taken over Sugar Rush under false pretenses. Because Vanellope has never been in a race, her attempt to win is the long shot of Act 5. Additionally, in order for her to even enter the race, Ralph must first enlist the aid of Felix to fix the cart Ralph smashed in the last act.
Please, Felix, fix it!
In this act, the character faces the strongest opposition of the story. For Ralph and Vanellope, this opposition initially comes from King Candy and the other Sugar Rush racers, but later intensifies with the attack of the Cybugs and the ultimate assimilation of the King into a Cybug supervirus. The Cybugs quickly overrun Sugar Rush, destroying the finish line before Vanellope can cross. Calhoun leads everyone to the exit, hoping to evacuate the game. Ralph tries to take Vanellope through the portal, but she can't pass through because she's a glitch. Knowing it's useless, Vanellope tells Ralph to go on without her.
It's okay, Ralph.
But as Calhoun prepares to destroy the exit to prevent the Cybugs from infecting the entire arcade, Ralph gets the idea to use Diet Cola Mountain as a beacon to destroy the Cybugs.
I got some wrecking to do!
Ralph attempts to smash the Mentos on Diet Cola Mountain to erupt the volcano. Before he can make the last strike, he's attacked by King Candy, who's been transformed into a giant Cybug. In his mutated form, Candy easily overpowers Ralph and forces him to watch as the Cybugs close in on Vanellope in the exit. With no other options at his disposal, Ralph frees himself and plummets toward the mountain to activate the beacon, seemingly sacrificing himself in the process. But Vanellope uses her fancy new glitching skills to rescue him at the last moment. Unable to resist the beacon, the Cybugs fly off to their death. King Candy, too, can't resist the light and finally gets his just desserts. Ralph has saved Vanellope and her game, and Felix gets the girl because Felix. In the new situation, Felix fixes the finish line, allowing Vanellope to cross it and reset the game, repairing all the damage and unlocking everyone's memory. It's then revealed that the glitch Vanellope is actually the princess of Sugar Rush, and she and Ralph are now friends. Ralph and Felix return to their game, which is now more popular than ever. Ralph now has a new appreciation for his role in the game, and the Nicelanders do as well. After 30 years, Ralph finally moves out of his dump. While Felix and Calhoun are married, Vanellope is now a real racer, all thanks to Wreck-It Ralph.
How bad can I be?
To learn more about six-act structure, pick up your copy of Actions and Goals, Story Structure Secret, on sale now, or visit sixactstructure.com for more film and novel breakdowns. If you enjoyed this video, be sure to like, subscribe, or drop a comment below.